Hello, people. I'm the Real Comic Book Gamer. Today, I'm going to be talking about Heroes in Crisis, because that's the new book that has been setting the world on fire that everyone's been complaining about or giving their opinions on either way. So, spoilers for this issue if you haven't read it, because I will be spoiling it, because I really want to talk about it. A lot of people have been talking about it, just read it. And, yeah, again, spoilers. If you haven't read it, leave now. Or if you don't care, then hello. But, yeah, there's your spoiler warning. So, big things happen in this issue. The big things are people die, which we already knew people were going to die. That was the big thing leading up to this issue was, oh, there's going to be a shooting at this sanctuary for, like, damaged superheroes. What's going to happen? And, yeah, we knew people were going to die. It was teased that it might be Wally West, because, like, every time there's a crisis, Flash has to die. And spoilers, it's Wally West. Wally West and Roy Harper were the big deaths. Other people died, but no one cares who else died. It's the two gingers that everyone cares about. The poor Roy and Wally. It really sucks that they died, and a lot of people are freaking out about it. But let's talk about the issue itself first, and then get into their deaths and my thoughts on all that. So, you have pretty much two storylines going on. Well, two places where you, like, the camera follows people pretty much, and that's Booster Gold and Harley Quinn are in, like, some diner, and they're talking. They have their own adventure sort of deal, and then you have the Trinity, so Batman, Wonder Woman, Superman, who are all converging on the Sanctuary. So if you don't know what the Sanctuary is, it is a safe haven for damaged superheroes. So if you've gone through trauma, you got PTSD, you're addicted to drugs, you need help, you need therapy, but you're a superhero, so you can't just go to normal people, you go here. Tom King said it's been around for 5 years in the DC universe, and it's set up by the Trinity, Superman, Batman, Wonder Woman, to help superheroes. So now there's a shooting there. This is Tom King's way of, like, sort of connecting with the modern world with all the shootings that happen and stuff, and he wanted to make a book about it, so he did. You have Superman going, and he gets to Sanctuary first because he's Superman, he's faster than Wonder Woman, Batman, so he gets there first, and he's finding all the dead bodies. They know something happened. Then you have Booster Gold and Harley Quinn, who are in this diner, and they're just talking, and I hate Harley Quinn so much. Her not being a villain is the most annoying thing, because basically all she does in this issue is stab Booster Gold about 1,000 times. Yes, Booster Gold, the guy that's known for having a force field, she stabs him a lot. Yeah, and it makes perfect sense. But she's just stabbing him the whole time. Booster Gold's not really fighting back. It's just like, oh, Harley, stop. And then she just keeps stabbing him. And they have a revelation in the end, which I'll get to in a bit. But Superman is going through, and he's, like, having a hard time seeing all these dead bodies. And then he gets to the big two, which are Roy Harper and Wally West. Those are the big two that died. Again, other people that died, but they weren't very big names, and they weren't, like, no one really cared. So these two die, and a lot of people are freaking out, understandably so, because they are big characters, and Wally West was just brought back during DC Rebirth. He was gone for a while. We didn't actually have Wally West, so sucks they killed him off now. But I'm gonna hold off judgment on this, like, freaking out completely until the end of the story arc, because who knows if all of this gets wrapped up in a nice neat little bow and Wally West and Roy Harper are back. And also, I don't know why Wally West was there, because Wally West wasn't, as far as I know, like, a damaged superhero. Like, we know why Roy Harper was there. He got re-addicted again, which is, I think, is stupid, because he had a cool arc where he actually got over being addicted, and, like, that was a big part of who he was, and now he's back because they don't know what to do, so they reuse plot lines, like, which happens a lot in comics, so they're doing that again. I'm not a fan of that, and they kill him off, and which really sucks, because Roy Harper hasn't really done anything cool since the New 52 started. There just hasn't been anything. He was part of, like, Red Hood and the Arsenals, which is, they kind of ruined his look. They gave him a stupid tattoo on his arm and a backwards hat, and that's what he wears, and he literally wears a baseball hat, and he has a tattoo, and I've hated his design ever since the beginning of New 52. But anyways, he's had some okay appearances here and there, but he hasn't really done much since New 52 started, so him getting killed off really sucks. Wally's done some cool stuff, just he's only been back since DC Rebirth, so he hasn't been back for very long, so kill him off right now is stupid. But again, I'm gonna hold off. If they're actually dead, and they're dead for a long time, I think that is stupid, and DC shouldn't have done this, and they shouldn't let Tom King do this, and this is stupid. My personal opinion, this would have been the perfect moment to make Harley Quinn snap and everyone realize, oh yeah, she's not a hero, she's pretending to be one of us, she's actually crazy and has murdered tons of people, and she was in love with the Joker. Have her snap inside that sanctuary and kill everyone. You know how great of a storyline that would be? I think that would be amazing, because everyone's, like, so sick of Harley, at least as far as I can tell, most people I see besides, like, cosplayers, are sick of Harley Quinn being a hero because it doesn't match with who she is and it's stupid. It's not a good redemption arc for someone that is psychotic and has murdered hundreds of people, or at least dozens of people, and that's it's just not good. Like, Tom King had an interview where he's talking about, oh, there were a bunch of fans I asked that said that they liked Harley Quinn because of her redemption arc.
I went to 1,000 cons, and you run to 1,000 cosplayers and asked every Harley cosplayer, like, what makes Harley specialty, and they all said the same thing. She's a survivor, she made a mistake in her life, she fell in love with the wrong guy, but she's coming back from that, and she's found strength in that, not because she rejects it, but because it's part of her, and it defines who she is.
She doesn't get to be redeemed when she's murdered dozens of people. That is not a good redemption arc. No, nope, 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 nope. Maybe I can understand maybe if you killed one person, even that's a little extreme, but you've killed tons of people and now suddenly you're a good guy because the fans like you, and it's just so stupid. So I think this would have been a great opportunity to have her snap inside the sanctuary, finally realize just like, yeah, this hero thing's not cut out for me, I'm done with it, I hate these people, and go stabby stab shooty shoot and kill everyone. I think that'd be cool. But instead, no, she just goes and she beats the crap out of Booster Gold, and then the end of the book, Booster's like, I saw you do it, and then she's like, no, you did it, Booster. And it's like, what? So I guess Booster Gold's killed all of them. He probably got like mind controlled by someone. I don't know. Then apparently I was reading somewhere else that more people might die in Heroes in Crisis. I don't know if the Nightwing amnesia arc is going to be connected to this. If you don't know, in Nightwing number 50, something's going to happen where he's going to get like shot in the head and get amnesia, and I was thinking that might happen in Heroes in Crisis issue number 1 since they're coming out around the same time, but no, it's not what's happening. So maybe later on he gets shot during Heroes in Crisis. That could be connected. I don't know. That's what I thought might happen, but no, just Wally and Roy die. And yeah, there's not much more to talk about with Heroes in Crisis. Just as of right now, Booster Gold's the one that killed everyone, and Roy and Wally are dead. I'm not a fan of it. The book wasn't terrible. Clayman's art is amazing, by the way. The writing itself wasn't my favorite, though, and I want to see how it pans out, though, before I fully judge this book, because who knows? In the end, it could all be undone. It could be a really good book, but as it stands right now, I'm not a fan. I think it's stupid. I think it's shock value, and I just hope they do better. I hope the future issues are better. At least the art is superb. Clayman does a fantastic job. He nails it so well. But yeah, those are my thoughts on Heroes in Crisis. Please let me know in the comments below if you have read this issue. What did you think about it? What are your guys' thoughts on this issue? Because stuff happened here. What do you think? And what are your predictions also for what's going to happen? You think someone else is going to die? You think Wally and them are going to be back? Because I just don't see Wally dying this fast after coming back. I know like Dan DiDio's always been like that, but I just don't see them doing that. It just doesn't add up to me. I think he'll be back by the end of Heroes in Crisis by whatever means, and we're going to find out why Wally was there. Because me right now, I don't know why Wally was there. Did he go because it was a distress call and he's the fastest guy in the DC universe? And they're like, oh, it's being shot up, so he runs there. And then again, how would he get shot? Even if it was Booster Gold, it doesn't make sense. But yeah, I want to hear your guys' theories in the comments down below and what did you think about it also. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed the video and I'll see you guys later.
Legends never die, we've been going every night. I've been feeling way too blessed, but with Lex I'm never stressed. They don't know just what we do, we've been out here with the crew. They don't know just how we live, think we got too much to give.